This week, Divi released Divi 3, a huge update to the Divi theme. In its review, I'll take it for a test drive, show you what it's like to use, and let you know if it's right for your next web project. I'm Tim from RealWebsiteHints.com, and it's my mission to help you find the best and easiest ways of making great websites. If you're interested in getting Divi 3, I'll include a sponsored link to Divi in the description below this video. So let's go ahead and dive in.
So the first thing I did after installing Divi 3 was to actually start doing some work at a couple of pages that I wanted to make for Real Website Hints. I have to say, I spent hours yesterday working on designing and tweaking pages in Divi 3, and not because Divi was hard to use, but because it was actually fun and a refreshing experience. It's not just a front-end page builder, but it's a really well-executed and thought-out page builder. So let's dive in and take a look. If you're new to building pages, there's a small learning curve with Divi 3. It's a front-end page builder that's based heavily on their back-end page builder. I found it really easy and intuitive to use because I've had so much experience with their back-end page builder, but if you're new to Divi, it might take you a little time to figure it out. But once you do, I think you'll find this the most enjoyable page building experience for WordPress. If you do need help getting started with the Divi theme, I'm working on a brand new course that I'll show you not just how to use the Divi theme, but also how to think about and build a really great website easily. I've got a link to that in the description below this video. You can also find more about that course at realwebsitehints.com/Divi. To get started building a page in Divi 3, you start out like you normally would creating a page in WordPress, and then you enable the Divi Builder. There's now a new button to enable the Visual Page Builder. Here, it's really easy to navigate and start building a page. Everything is color coordinated, so it's easy to tell if you're highlighting a section, a row, or a module. One thing that I really like about this visual builder over the other ones that I've tested is that it doesn't take up any extra space in your window. There's no fixed bars on the top or on the side of your window. It just feels much more open that way. And when you need to add a module, you just click a button and the module window opens up and it's ready for you to pick a module that you want. And I really like the module search feature. Once you know what the different modules are in Divi, it's really fast to just type in the module that you want and then it just pops right up. They've made it really simple to edit text. And this is really great for updating content in your webpage, which I know is kind of frustrating when you're using a back-end builder because you have to figure out where the module is and then go into it. Here with Divi 3, it is so simple. You simply just find the text that you want to change, you click on it, and you just change it. I also really like the fact that you can change the font or the color of the font just by highlighting it and changing it. One thing that I did have a problem with, which I'm sure they're going to fix pretty soon, that I found adjusting the font size in this shortcut mode for editing text was kind of hit or miss. Sometimes it worked, sometimes it didn't work. So I really hope that they resolve that issue soon. But right now, I found that their best and most reliable way to adjust text is to simply just go inside the settings of the module and then click on the Design Settings tab, and then that brings up all of the settings for adjusting the text size either for your header text or for your body text. Divi is a fully responsive theme. That means that it will automatically reformat your pages so that they look great on any screen size. One thing that Divi does better than other page builders is that if you want to, you can really tailor the viewing experience of your site based on the type of device that your users are using. Most modules have special size settings that you can easily customize based on the device size. You can also turn on or turn off specific sections so that they can be displayed on mobile devices or not on mobile devices, and that's up to you. But of course, the standard responsiveness of the Divi theme does work really well, but if you really want to fine-tune it, you've got that option. The new Divi Visual Builder also offers several view options to help you make those adjustments. They have a zoomed out view so you can get a larger view, or sort of an overview of your site, a desktop setting, tablet setting, and phone setting. So if you really want to fine-tune the experience of your viewers on a different device, you can. The builder also comes with a really nice feature to undo and redo. If you make a change and then you want to undo it, you've got a few options. One is to just press the Command-Z or Control-Z if you're on a PC, and we'll undo your changes. If you're working inside of a module, there are undo and redo buttons right at the bottom of the module. Then in the bottom tray where the page controls are, there's also a history view that you can use to go back to previous changes that you've made. Overall, I really enjoyed the front-end page building experience with Divi 3. I did have a few times where selecting the gear icon for a specific module was a little bit fidgety, but overall it was a really good experience. I also like knowing that I can always go and edit the page from the back-end builder if need be, but so far I've been really happy with the visual builder. The overall main site design controls for Divi use the WordPress Theme Customizer function. I like seeing theme developers embrace the features that WordPress has added. This really helps make a more unified feeling WordPress experience. If you build sites for other people, or if you have other people who contribute to your site, you're probably really going to like Divi's user role control features. This allows you to turn on and off access of all sorts of functions in the theme and of the builder. This is a really great tool that helps keep people from messing up the beautiful site that you've created with Divi. So is it all sunshine, rainbows, and puppy dogs? There's a couple of things that might bother you. One thing is the occasional fidgetiness of getting the settings button on the visual builder that I already mentioned. Also, remembering to save. The save button is at the bottom tray of the main page settings. By default, this tray is closed, so you've got to remember to open up the page settings tray, click on the save button before exiting the builder. The save button really should have been either next to the exit page builder button at the top, or like on the Beaver Builder page builder plugin, where when you click to exit the page builder, it asks you if you'd like to save. Another thing that I don't really see as a problem, but some people really freak out about this, is that if you decide for some reason to switch themes from the Divi theme, I can't imagine why you'd want to do that once you've started building your site with Divi, but if for some reason you wanted to, Divi does leave behind shortcodes. That's how the page builder works. It's actually how most page builders that I've tested works, is they use the shortcodes to call the actual code that they use to build and design your site. I really don't see this as a huge issue, though, for two reasons. One is that with Divi, you can build just about any kind of site. It's kind of a one theme builds anything theme. Secondly, you can always download and install the Divi Page Builder plugin, which then allows the pages that you've made with Divi to look normal on other themes. Overall, I really like the Divi theme. It's the theme that I use for Real Website Hints, and I've been using it for several years now. I really respect the developers behind Divi, and they have shown a constant commitment to improving and adding new, better, and genuinely useful features to the theme. The last major update, before Divi 3, added the ability to save single pages. This is an awesome feature. It allows you to work on a test site on another server or on your computer and design and build a page and then upload it to your main website and then quickly update an existing page to your live site without having to do anything complicated or confusing or actually editing a page on your live site. This has also opened up the ability to download page templates for Divi that other people have made. So Divi's released a bunch of different page templates that you can use on your site, and then other people who are part of the Divi community are also making various different page templates. And I think that is a really awesome and excellent time saver to have other pages that are already pre-built out there that you can just load onto your site and then make quick edits to and make it your own. Divi is an easy and accessible theme, and I think it's great for beginners, but it also offers a lot of power features. This makes it an incredible tool, not just for beginners who want to make their site, but it's actually a great tool for professional web designers to use. One of the power features that I am really impressed by is the built-in A-B split testing. So you can test multiple different headlines, images, or buttons and see what's actually resonating with your viewers. This is the kind of feature that you could pay hundreds of dollars a year to implement from an outside company, or you could just get it included as part of the Divi theme. So the licensing for Divi is pretty straightforward. Their base tier is access to the Divi theme, plus all of the themes made by the Divi theme developers. And at the time I recorded this, that was $69 for 1 year of technical support and 1 year of updates. You can build an unlimited number of sites with that. And then after the 1 year, the theme and the sites that you build will still work. You just won't have access to support or theme updates. The next tier is $89, which gives you access to all the themes made by the Divi developers, as well as all of their plugins. And one of the plugins that they make that I particularly like is the Bloom email opt-in plugin. Divi does offer email opt-in functionality, but with Bloom, it takes it to the next level. It adds advanced programmable pop-ups to your email opt-in. And at this tier, you also get 1 year of updates and 1 year of technical support. The final tier is the one that I wish I had signed up for when I got the Divi theme. This is the same as the second tier, but it also includes lifetime updates and support. This tier is a bit of a step up in price at $259, but I think that if you're serious about making a quality website for yourself, it's well worth it. The developers of Divi have done such an incredible job of continual improvement to the theme that I look at it as having paid a one-time fee for an amazing development team that is constantly working to make my website better. And then I think if you're building websites for other people, that this is the obvious choice to make.
So if you're interested in getting the Divi theme, check out the sponsored link below this video. If you want some help building your first website with Divi, check out the information on my online course in the description below and at realwebsitehints.com/Divi. For more themes reviews, tips, and tricks to help you build websites easily, be sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel and visit me at realwebsitehints.com. If you have a question or a tip of your own, leave it in the comments below. Thanks for watching.